The first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, when that which is mortal clothes itself with immortality, then the word that is written shall come about. Death is swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is victory? Where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is in the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Otherwise, wala tayong magiging ng magandang sapatos. parto sa si Nena. And then I saw the sacrifice of my mom. You know, early in the morning, as early as 4 o'clock. Sabi ko, hindi pa naman yung panggabi, aga-aga na yun. Wala naman tayong mapapalagin. Sabi niya, no. Tawag dito, tayo na maaga ang asipan. Ang sabi niya sa akin, you know, our mothers teaches us the lessons of life. You know? So, when we looked at Mary, she is also our mother. We looked up to her, and we see the sacrifices she had embraced for us. Because in the church, the church teaches us, who is also our mother, you know, teaches us that everything that God wants to fulfill in us, she first showed us, and she had fulfilled in Mary, his own mother. When we were seminarians, Bishop Makani, many of you know who Bishop Makani is, he gave a very beautiful presentation on the eve of the Assumption. Sabi niya, kung nakapagpadala ang tao sa buwan, Diyos pa kaya, how can he not bring the body and soul of his loving mother, living tabernacle, living Ark of the Covenant into heaven, to show us what is truly our destiny. Our destiny is heaven. Hindi po ito ang ating eternal dwelling place. You know? That's why it is sad when you hear in the news a man gave so much laughter and joy in the life of people and the person of Robin Williams killed himself. What's the problem? Have they forgotten that there is a God who died for them? And that's what Mary did. She's always reminding us, not just of the sacrifice of Jesus on the cross, but also his resurrection. She's reminding us too, that there is a glory that awaits us, not here, but in heaven. I remember her words to St. Bernadette when she appeared, as Our Lady of Lourdes, I cannot promise to make you happy here on earth, but yes, in heaven. She is always there waiting for us and continually encouraging us to persevere in faith, to embrace the cross of Christ so as to share in his resurrection. And how do we embrace the cross of Christ? By putting to life to practice the word of God. You know, in the gospel, Jesus said, yes, we're saying that blessed are the womb that bore me and the breast that nursed me. No, but the Blessed Mother is more blessed because she heard the word of God and she believed it with all her heart. And that's what we heard in the story of the Annunciation. She said, how can this be? I do not know, man. I have, in Spanish, it was also expressed differently. Yo permanezco virgen. I promise God to just be a virgin for him. How come God is a different plan? But then she also said, when the angel Gabriel explained to her what the plan of God is, that she will remain a virgin, even though she will also be the mother of God, she said, I am the servant of the Lord. Let it be done to me as you say. That is our calling. To follow her example, to say, like the Blessed Mother on the eve of her Assumption, God's victory over death, over the corruption of death. No? To say, like Mary, I am the servant of the Lord. I will fear neither death nor corruption, because the Lord is my shepherd. Though I walk in the valley of darkness, I shall fear no evil, for you are with me. Kasama natin si Maria sa paglalakad dito sa lupa patungo sa langit over them. As she had crossed over the waters of death, we too will cross too with her, not by ourselves, but with her, and with Jesus, who is our resurrection and the life. It is very interesting that when we begin this weekend retreat for women, that we celebrate this vigil of the Assumption. It's like she's calling us, consecrate yourself to me, to Jesus, through me, so that I may show you the true path to holiness. Today, this morning, we celebrated a wonderful feast day of St. Maximilian Kolbe. He lived during our century, during this time. And he said, he wrote, that hatred is not a creative force. It is only love that it has a transforming power, creative and transforming power. And he showed that love by offering his life in place of a prisoner who was a family man and a married man. He said to the executioner, "I am a Catholic priest. I will take the place of that man who was married and has children." And he said, "I want to become a saint as soon as possible. You too are called to be saints. We, like him, should aspire to that." And she loved Mary so much that she built a city in Poland called the Metropolis of the Immaculate. And then he also formed a congregation called the Militia for the Knights of the Immaculate. There are brothers who dedicated themselves to propagating the good news in the name of Mary and with the prayers of our Blessed Mother. Today, as we begin this weekend retreat, let us offer to Jesus all our works, all our intentions, all our prayers, with the help of Mary, our Mother, to Jesus, through Mary. Amen. Please stand. Confident that our